I'll show up at game conventions and, you know, Comic-Con and BotCon and things like that. And I'll get somebody saying, how come you killed Optimus Prime?
When I first read the script,
I cried when you killed Optimus Prime.
I saw that Optimus Prime dies.
It's like, well, I was young, acting under orders.
I was shocked. And I thought then that kids all over the world would be incredibly despondent over this.
But the real answer is that we didn't know that he was an icon.
Optimus, forgive me.
Yeah, you know, the reality is at the time what we thought of the show as being, it was a toy show. We just thought we were killing off the old product line, introducing the new products. And you know, Optimus Prime was one of those guys.
We felt, and they felt, the time for a new generation of heroes. And so it was an opportunity to do something that had never been done before because nobody died on television.
We thought there was a chance to update the character, update the Transformer world, and let him fight the really great, strong, historic battle, which he fights in the film, that you know kids everywhere wanted to see and wanted to see what happened.
And then bring on a new hero, Hot Rod becomes Rodimus Prime. And so everybody was for that.
Megatron must be stopped, no matter the cost.
We tried to play that moment as human die. You know, it's not just robotic die. You can feel the emotions. You can see humanity, you know?
But then, of course, when the film came out, and there was this hue and cry from parents about, how can you kill off Optimus Prime? My kids are so upset, and all of that. Then we thought, you know, I think maybe we went too far.
From my understanding, it had huge impacts. All of the children that I know and everything that loved Transformers and loved Optimus Prime were just overtaken with grief.
As I am director, I'm not going to know what's the react from the audience.
Yeah, kids were crying in the theaters. We were hearing about people leaving the movie. We're getting a lot of nasty notes about it. And indeed, we had some kid that locked himself in his bedroom for 2 weeks.
Do not grieve.
Nobody had the heart to tell him was we already had an episode in the pipeline where Optimus comes back as a zombie and you kill him all over again.
Soon, I shall be one with the Matrix.
The kind of interesting coda to the killing Optimus Prime story is the scene that never did make it into the Transformer movie. Well, you know, next season we're gonna have all these new characters and people are gonna be wondering what happened to the old characters that they like so much. And what we knew in a business sense is, well, they'd been discontinued because they were the 84 line, but we gotta tie them off. So you had this one scene where the Autobots basically had to run through a gauntlet of Decepticons, which basically wiped out the entire 84 product line in one massive charge of the Light Brigade. So whoever wasn't discontinued, like, stumbled to the end. Yeah, that, of course, never made it into the movie. But if you think kids are locking themselves into the room over Optimus Prime, you know, basically in that scene, they would have seen their entire toy, you know, collection wiped out. The funny thing about killing Optimus Prime is it probably gave the movie its resonance.
To show someone dying and the leader dying, I think, was a powerful thing. And I think that's one of the reasons why it's lasted as long as it has, because we did things that weren't being done at that time.
It was very pivotal for a child's growth and for the fans of Transformers.
There was a thought in my head that I'd be sitting here 20 years later talking about the Transformer movie.
And I think it followed them all through their life. It has mine.
I think in retrospect, we might not have killed Optimus Prime off if we had to do it all over again.
Until that day. Till all are one.